What is up, guys? Welcome on back to TK's Garage, and I was going to say Recall's Garage because that's what we're talking about today. Can you believe it? A company is making headlines for having more recalls than Stellantis. I know, it's a shocker.
For the longest time, whoa, for the longest time.
What is up, guys? Welcome on back to TK's Garage. And in today's video, Ford is the king of recalls. Again, I mean, literally for the last 3 years, go look at the data back to back to back. In fact, I think Car Scoops posted the following, boom, back in December, showing that they were the king of recalls 3 years in a row. And oh my God, we're only halfway through, or just past halfway in 2024. And boom, Ford has recalled more cars in 2024 than GM, Honda, Toyota, Nissan, VW, and BMW combined. Damn. So as you guys can see here, almost 3.7 million Ford vehicles have been caught up in 31 recalls, and we're only halfway through the year. This was over on carscoops.com. Tesla is the next worst, announcing 8 recalls for 2.6 million cars, though some problems were handled by over-the-air updates. I don't know if those really count then. Ford's big rival, GM, because that's the only one left, because they said, you know, Chrysler's not an American company anymore, has only recalled 655,867 vehicles in 2024. So, as they even said here on Car Scoops, Ford is nothing but, if not consistent, the American arm of the company got the quality control wooden spoon in 2023. For the third year running, based on both the number of recalls that announced and the number of cars caught up in those campaigns. So, 54 recalls covering 5.6 million, actually closer to 5.7 million vehicles across the whole of 2023. But with only 6 months in this year, Ford and its Lincoln subsidiary has already announced 31 recalls that affect 3.6 million cars. I mean, think about that. Last year, 4.69, and already this year, 3.66 million. I mean, oof. I mean, and here's, if you don't understand why this is bad, if you're a Ford guy or have Ford stock, you know, every time they do one of these recalls, if it costs money for them to issue do a service to be able to repair or fix whatever the recall is in these vehicles, all of that costs money. All of that comes out of the bottom line of the company being profitable or running at a loss. And this might be part of the reason why Ford is like, F this EV crap. We need to build as many trucks as possible so that we can be profitable. That would not surprise me in the least. But anyways, I wanted to bring this story to you guys and see what you guys thought about it. You know, it shocked me to see the amount of vehicles. But then again, you know, because people will be like, oh, TK, you always pick on Stellantis, but you don't say anything about Ford. And then I do. I get dead into Ford's ass. But here's the difference. Ford, and I know someone's going to be like, well, they didn't buy back my vehicle. Ford doesn't have the issues. Like, we'll be doing videos on the Hornet here soon, where literally 8 out of 10 customers that buy the Dodge Hornet hate it. And they don't hate it because they didn't like the way it drove. They hate it because it's in the service department more than your favorite BMW. And they don't have fixes. And they sit for 4 or 5 months. And they go through buybacks and lemon law claims because Stellantis doesn't want to buy them back. Ford doesn't have that issue. You buy a Dark Horse Mustang and there's something wrong with it, it's been in for 3 repairs, they're like, here's a check. Have a nice day, sir. You get an F-150, a couple of things have gone wrong with it. You brought it in 2 or 3 times. You go through their buyback department. Here's a check. Done. Stellantis ain't doing that. They are the most penny-pinching, sorry SOBs ever. And to see this going on with Ford, it sucks. It does suck for the bottom line if you're an investor, but at least they're taking care of their issues. You know, we'll see how it fares in the future. But I want to know what you guys think. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Give the video a big thumbs up if you like what I do. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. And as always, stay petty, my friends.